Welcome to Goodnight, Robin. You're someone to say goodnight to. I'm your host, Robin Rice. I am so excited to announce that Shalia is our first corporate underwriter of Goodnight, Robin. Shalia is a pharmaceutical-grade skincare line that I personally use that is now available to the public. Shalia says you are beautiful, you are confident, you are strong. Let Shalia take you on a journey to total wellness inside and out, body, mind, and soul. To learn more, visit Shalia Botanicals, that's S-H-A-L-I-A, botanicals.com, and of course the link is in our show notes. Today I was walking and thinking about Mother Teresa. Now, Mother Teresa is one heck of a woman, was one heck of a woman, now a saint. And I am no saint, that's for sure. But I do like to wonder if, when I create a podcast, if she would approve, if Mr. Rogers would approve, if some of my idols, if you will, would approve, people that I look up to. And one of the things that Mother Teresa said that I have always kept in my mind is that people are difficult. Love them anyway. And, you know, that's easier said than done. But I do find that we're all difficult. We're all difficult in our own ways. There's nobody who's not in some way that I know anyway. My guess is even Mother Teresa was difficult, depending on who was the one thinking about her. She was a pretty tough cookie. And she asked a lot of people. She asked people to be better than they normally would have been. Maybe not the person dying on the street, but the people who supported her and gave her money to make things happen and all that sort of thing. And I always thought, gosh, it's great to say, you know, love them anyway. And you can get angry with someone and go, love them anyway, love them anyway, love them anyway. but I actually had another person say to me something that really worked. And they said, you know, most people are struggling, as we all know, and most people have stories that we will never hear about why they're doing what they're doing or why they're cranky or whatever. And he said, I just kind of look when people misbehave, and he called it misbehaving, or that's what he called it. I thought it was interesting. When people misbehave, I just think of them sort of like an old man passing gas. Like, you don't blame him for it. It's just natural. It's just something that happened. You don't call him out and put him on a stage, or, you know, you just say, oh, well, we'll ignore that. And that actually helped me think about how I could imagine someone behaving badly, and even me behaving badly. Sometimes that happens. Sometimes we're just old men passing gas. It's kind of a stark and funny way to look at it, but it actually worked when I put it towards Mother Teresa, because I'm sure she was, you know, she was constantly in situations where things were not ideal, where things smelled bad, where things didn't look good. And she found a way to overlook all of that. She saw everything as love, I believe. So I thought, well, that's an interesting way to look at it. That's what I do now. Is when someone's behaving badly, I try. Don't always succeed, but I try to think, eh, that's just an old man passing gas. And it kind of makes me laugh. And somehow takes the edge off of whatever's going on. Anyway, I thought I would tell you about that today. Don't ask me why I needed to talk about that today as far as someone acting badly. We don't need to go into that story. But just so you know, my life's not perfect, and I act badly, and other people act badly, and sometimes Mother Teresa is necessary. I hope she would approve of this message. That's my story for tonight. Love to you, my friends. Good night.